And so today, I'm the bullfrog at Baltimore's gate. So in this vid, we have a look at some interesting abandoned stuff. Historical as well. I got a friend in Scotland who sends me videos of abandoned places in Scotland. So this one's for him, partly. Obviously an old fort once upon a time. It was decommissioned, I believe, back in the 70s. I believe some proving and testing went on here, as at the Aberdeen Proving Ground. Got a cobblestone driveway here, but growing over, leading to a former proving area, I believe. There are a bunch of tunnels and that sort of thing here as well. Over here to the right, a dead-end, narrow corridor of sorts. It looks spookier than it is. It goes about maybe 30 feet and then dead-ends. But to the right of this, a stairway to heaven, or to some place, to the top of an old area. This hillside you see here is actually hollow. There's a chamber inside there that can't be reached anymore. And directly behind me, another hollow hillside with a huge chamber inside behind those doors. But of course I can't open them right now. But I can almost see a little crack of light through there. Very, very faintly. Don't know if the camera will pick it up. I tried. But there's a huge space inside there. Over here, a building that was once one of the many power stations at this fort. Now it's a bathroom and comfort center. Still full of it. Looking almost Mexican-like. Well, doesn't it? And over here, FYI for you. And over here, another area like that first area that we checked out, with underground chambers beneath the hills, housing, or once housed, all kinds of military items. And one more stairway to heaven, or wherever it might be going. Another dead-end corridor there. As I said, it looks spookier than it is. It only goes 30 feet and then dead ends. But my assumption is the one time didn't dead end. And again, directly behind, the other entrance to the big chamber that I tried showing you from the other side. What could have been in there at one time, or might still be in there now? And if you're old enough to remember a 60s TV show called Doctari, this building looks like it was in that show. I assume it's a former office building. And yes, I will take you inside. You're going to thank me for it. That is, if I come out alive. cool old steps. And here it is. In all its former splendor. Got a corridor here leading to separate, I guess, X cubicles, whatever. Area was divided up. All kinds of office rooms here. Both on the left and on the right. And all with doors to adjacent rooms. One can get lost here if one wants to. Even an upstairs chamber. But obviously not used in a while. And the direction we came from. Yeah, her too. Alright, time to step out. Next on our tour is this place. And the pier where the former gun turrets would have been. There, and of course, one on the opposite side. Through the trees would be the Chesapeake Bay. Of course, the trees weren't here when the fort was built. And you could see who's coming up the bay. And there's the other turret. And through here, you can almost make out the bay through the trees. I said almost. There are many ins and outs to this place. Obviously at one time, a huge operation before its closing. They used to do combat training here up until the 70s. And some of that combat training was done with very controversial methods, like having naked soldiers hold center blocks out with each arm at arm's length for a certain length of time. You try that. If you drop it, the sergeant laughs at you. We've been here all this time, and they're finally welcoming us. Took long enough. And now by the area where they kept lookout over the bay. First, check out this here secret passage. I guess now not too secret. Just a small room, that's all. No longer a secret anyway, but nice echo. Hello. I know what to do. Regola. I'm out of here. A little ways back, I was looking for a secret basement at the Merryman's graveyard. Will this one do? Now directly above the secret room, where the wind is blowing, and again the bay through the trees, believe me, it's there. And barking dogs too. And down here another building where there were offices and things. It looks like an old movie set. There's some nice dark corridors here too, but they're locked up and inaccessible. But this almost looks like a POW camp, the way it's set up. Be funny if that's what it was at one time. A prisoner of war camp. All the windows are barred. Well, I can go in. Do I dare? You betcha. Now I'm inside whatever this thing's supposed to be. Another chamber over here. But no way out. So gotta reverse. And across the way there, another powerhouse. And here it be. Got a picnic table there in case you get hungry. And the chamber here that you can walk through and come out the other side. Let's see if one can still do that. Yeah, one can. Hope there's no sinkhole or anything here. Yeah, sure enough. And I'm back out. Still, one very interesting area to explore. And over here, one more hole I can crawl into with dripping water like a cave. Noises. Now that sounds spooky. I'm not going in there. I'm out of here. Over here, stairs leading halfway to heaven. Well, quarter of the way anyway. Let's see what's up here. Oh, just a sidewalk and a shortcut to somewhere. Looked like an old concrete road. Over here, one more of these. Just like the battery clacket we saw a few minutes ago. Same in principle and concept. I can go inside here. Let me see if I dare do it. Well, got a messed up floor though. Like the inside of a cave. I mean, I'd rather be cave exploring than this. Considerably safer. At least it's got a window, unlike most caves. I know what. Push her in and lock the door. Keep her out of my face for a bit. Bye. And now on the roof of the building. It looks like a POW camp. And apparently some stuff went on here too. That can't be a gun turret. It's too low. Not sure what that is. Got a lookout area over there. Another room's inside. Here's one of the lookout rooms, but you can't look out over the bay because of the growth, as mentioned earlier. Nice view of the growth, though. But you come here, you become like the curious cat. But then again, look how the cat wound up. one time this place was obviously heavily fortified. And one of the many graffiti rooms you find here. If these folks were to get a real campus, instead of using these walls, they could make some money. We'll take a break from history for a bit and go down by the bay. Ooh. Oh, a row of balloons there. I'll see someone's birthday. All right, check out the bay. And over there, the dock on the bay. I think I'll go sit on it. Like that 60s song. Got some rough seas today. Or rough bay, whatever. Over the horizon is the Bay Bridge, but hard to pick out. Got a cruise ship there in the distance. But there it goes, off on its merry way. Now taking the scenic route around the bay. Let's see where we end up. Across the water is the Brandon Shores power plant. There you go. There across the bay. And over there, the Key Bridge. And part of the point. As in Sparrow's Point. There across Chesapeake Bay. Chesapeake Bay, I like that. Chesapeake Bay. Now that's a cool name. Meanwhile, back at the fort, nothing happening, but a ways back something would have been. Another battery thing here, but don't know the name of this one, there's no sign up. Call it Battery Bullfrog. That has a certain ring to it. Let's peek inside here. All crowded inside there. They're storing stuff in there. Welcome to something. I don't want to find out what. And now we're paralleling the fence that separates us from the former Fort Howard Hospital. Over there. Remember that sidewalk you saw a little ways back? Now we're at the other end of it. As we still straddle the fence between us and the hospital. And one more view of Fort Howard Hospital. But don't know if it's still being used as such. Now we're almost back at our starting point. But at one time I thought there was a house that sat there. Nothing there now. Didn't notice it before. Talk about change blindness. Still amazing. All the stuff that once transpired here. Last time we were here, back in 2011, there were skeeters biting us, but so far none that I know of. I'm not itching yet. Nope, ain't got the itch quite yet. So there you have it, your bullfrog at Baltimore's gate. Need I say more?